At that time, the magnificent Mahabodhisattva Devaraja rose up from the first row of the Sangha and bowed three times towards the Blessed One, thus expressing the sovereign and unquestionable power of the Buddha Dhamma. The thundering Mahabodhisattva Devaraja generated a perfect beam of undivided awareness power that penetrated the minds and spirits of all who were present in the great assembly. Devaraja's wondrous Manomakaya body vibrated with perfect thusness in the ageless Sampakaya continuum, with its boundless light of compassion encompassing the assembly. Skillfully aware of their diverse spiritual attributes as he knelt down in absolute allegiance to the Tathagata, he praised the Tathagata's immeasurable nature by thusly addressing the Blessed One with a perfect wordless transmission that expounded the direct spiritual link between no thought and no mind known only as such in the supra-essential and auspicious Tathatic light. Blessed One, great ignorance afflicts the spirit of the dreaming, and thus the pure light of your supreme body appears to them as apparently defiled. Its noble stature remains veiled as water's true nature is concealed to a fish, that, in accord with its preconditioned and instinctual habit energy, swims about oblivious to the habitat that freely propels its movement. Unable to recollect your supreme body of undivided awareness, the suffering continually abide in the self-empty dominion of their innermost desires and fears, thus mistaking the false to be true and the true to be false. Mara's inverted light creates myriad inverted realms within the clouded mind that can be dissolved by freely discerning the true light of your compassionate sovereign will. Stripped of the true nature of their true self, the children of no self are like embalmed inhabitants within the lower regions of the unwholesome. Blessed One, entrapped within the empty bubble of myriad dream worlds, they wander aimlessly about within the ever-changing maze that is likened to a morphic desire field, one that constantly inverts itself into new shifting shapes, desire bodies from the smallest into the largest and from the largest into the smallest, all vibrating interdependently as an eternal cycle of cosmic breath found within the smallest and largest alike, and apparently seen as something arising out of apparent nothingness and also as this something becoming apparently nothing. It is a glimmering and ever-fleeing mirage that promises much to those who thirst, but containing nothing essential that would alleviate all their suffering and longing for self-fulfillment. By this continuous act of dependent origination, Blessed One, I observe myriad generations appearing as demons, hungry ghosts, beasts and worldlings, as well as semi, devas and devas, right up to great Brahmas, all concerned with the ability to desire and create, to destroy and reshape, all greatly distressed by the agitated waves that appear in the great ocean of their own ignorance as they foolishly and desperately seek even a drop of permanence in the apparently ever-changing. Blessed One, all such phenomena are nothing but deludidacts of the sensuous non-self, that evil beast whose myriad abilities are known by we Mahabodhisattvas as the ideated embodiment of unwholesome desire and self-regenesis, the body consciousness. Blessed One, this no-self is a beast of cunning deception, for it is since beginningless time preset to be so through endless desires of the dreaming. Thus it has grown, allowing itself to grow, in the divided and inverted light of your originally undivided light of noble wisdom, acting as a corrupt advisor who whispers into the ears of the weak, who in their eagerness to please their desires, have forgotten their true nature and turned and divided the Bodhi power of their spirit and mind, in interdependent origination with this beast of suffering. Blessed One, This beast, once it is created in the modulating Bodhi act of unwholesome desire and self-ignorance, miraculously is brought to life. It runs away like a starving, bewildered animal, endlessly craving to fill its bottomless belly with all kinds of food, never being satisfied with the impermanent state of things. It wreaks havoc and suffering upon anyone who may cross its path. Blessed one, so easily can the artificial and divided light of this no-self enchant the most refined minds of the dreaming, that not even their deepest suffering can awaken them. Indeed, by beginningless habit, they pay complete allegiance to this no-self as it is created in the inverted light of their first defilement, and will haunt them until the temporal moment of their last one. In countless worlds and countless desire bodies,